Hello guys, welcome to Embedotronics. This is Pawan. We are again here with 8051 tutorials. If you guys are not following my tutorials, just go visit my channel and you will see there we have started 8051 tutorials. So one by one you will understand how 8051 can interface with lots of devices. There we have already told LCD 7 segment using keypad and some kind of counting and all we have already done. So here what we are going to do today using 8051, I will tell you how we can make a simple digital clock. Simple means in the coding part we will not use any interrupt and timer and all, because still I didn't tell you about those things, so we will just go through that also. But here without using these things, simply using a delay function and how we can increment these segments, means like the kind of multiplexing we will do here. So definitely we have, you can see in this Proteus simulation, we have connected six segments to single port only, and that is nothing but this P2, and these are control pins. Why I am saying control pins to these pins? Because these pins are just to enable the segment. So suppose I want to enable any single segments of one, suppose this segment I want to enable, so I'll just give one to this and other will be zero, so this segment will be turned on. So this way these things are working. So how this digital clock we will make, I'll just show you the coding part so that you will understand. So here we have used this Keel software, and here you can see this code is there. You can see here we have defined first this header file, so everything, whatever port and all is defined in this file, we can use these things. So now here you can see what one preprocessor directive we have defined, msec equals to msec 1, now msec will be 1, and here an unsigned int array 10, this is a normal array, and here in this array we are just defining the 7 segments hex code. These 7 segment hex codes are representing numbers in 7 segments. How this segment code we generated, you just follow one tutorial. We have already covered that tutorial. Just go visit that channel and just see how to interface 7 segment display to 8051. You will come to know how this segment code are coming. I will just put that link in the description below. You can find from there as well. And now here you can see these are the segments. We have 6 7 segments are there, so these are the control pins of our 7 segment, D4, D3, D2, D1, D0, and last one is D. So this way we have connected to P1, we have taken P1 port for control pins, so 0 to 5 we have covered. Now here some variables we have took, V1, 2, V6, total 7 variables we have took. I'll tell you how these things are defined in the program below. And here this is delay function, so we'll just go to the main function first. Delay function is nothing but just a simple for loop is there. Here you can see, now here in the main function you can see first we are telling that all the variables of till V1 from this V6 are 0 initially. Okay, fine, let's move to the while loop. Here while loop you can see, now I'm telling, just forget this thing first. I'll indent these things so that this thing will tell you later why these things I'm using. Now here you can see if v1 equals, first we are just incrementing v1, v1 equals to v1 plus 1, and then we are telling p2, initially p2 we have all that 1 1 is there. Now we are just turning on one segment and other 5 segments are turning off. So it means D is representing, I'll show you in this, D means this segment is denoted with D, because this control pin is going from this last control pin, which is nothing but which is connected to 6, and 6 is connected to this P1.5. So this P1.5 is D, and D is representing this segment. So we are just turning on this and these 5 segments will be turned off. So here, here you can see in P2 we are just first initializing with these values, then we are passing P2 in P2 a array V1, and V1 is nothing but now it is V1 plus 1. So initially 1 will go to this P2 and then delay will come, and again in another case V1 equals 10, so V1 will not be 10 until unless this things again when it will come to another, means like second cycle V1 will increment, so V1 is nothing but only 1, so it will not go to this condition. So again that this it will come out of this if condition, and here these things will happen. So now D0 is 1 and other segments will be 0. So in second case this will be on and other 4, 5 will be off, and third case this will be on, other 5 will be off, then this will be on, then this other 5 will be off, and then this and then this. So but the thing is how we are saying that one segment at a time, obviously one segment will be on and others will be off, but human this is called persistence of vision, we can say. Actually in reality only one segment is switched on and other segments are switched off. So the thing is but human eye will think like, means human eye will see like all segments are switching on, means like all the segments are turned on. So simply we cannot able to determine whether one segment is on or not. All we will, it will means like we will see like all the segments are turning on. So this is the case. Now if I'll just go to again this code, I'll show you. So here you can see all the condition we have put like that only. So at a time we are on switching on one segment and another 5 will be off, and we are doing these things so fast so that it be, means like it will, it is looking like that all the segments are at a time switching on. So here you can see if in the condition why we wrote like that, if V1 equals 10, then we are incrementing the, because initially this will be this will be, when it will go till to 10, then we are incrementing to this. So we are saying that whenever it will be 10, so it will be 0 and this will be 1. So same way when this will be, because in 1 minute 60 seconds are there, so now I am telling when it will be 6, then this will be 1. So same way now when this will be 10, then this will be 1 and this will be 0. And same way this will, when it will reach, because this is a minute, these two segments are for minute. So when it will be 6 now, then this will, these two will be 1 and 2. So whenever this is 1 and this is 2, so we are making all the segments 0. You can see here, whenever V1 equals 10, then this, then V2 equals, see we are using, for V2 we are using 6, as I told you, because seconds will go from till 60. So V2 again we are making 0 and we are incrementing the next segment as from this V2. So this is V3. Now the same way we are just assigning this ARR V3 to P2, segment is getting that. Now if V3 equals 10, then V3 is 0 and V4 is incrementing. Same way one segment is on, another 5 are off, and then we are assigning this array to P2. Now V4 I'm saying like 6, because that this is now minute segment. So minute also will be 60 only. So whenever this will reach till 6, then V4 again we are making 0 and V5 is incrementing. And this way again, once this segment is on and others are off, and now V5 is 10, then V5 is 0 and V6 are incrementing. So this way of now, in the last condition you can see if V6, because these are the last two segments, if because it is a 12 hours clock, just you think like that way. So if V6 equals to 1 and V5 equals to 2, so whenever this will be like that, then all the segments are 0, because it is representing 12 o'clock. So after 12 o'clock again we are starting with 0. So this way these things are working. And this is this first thing which I indented, this thing I am using just to use delay, you can say, because here it is just waiting condition for this. If loop is for waiting condition, so that it will reach count till 130, and 130 times it will repeat. Any number you can put this number, I just in using simulation, I just hit and trial way, I just got this number. So in hardware if you'll do, this number would be different, and delay time also would be different, that delay part is also there. So these two things, you just, if you are doing it in hardware, so these two things would be different, but you can, by hit and trial you can get that thing. So this is not the means like by if you, I'll talk about the accuracy, this would not be the accurate clock, as we didn't give the accurate time using timer, we didn't give delay. But definitely by hit and trial you can get the accuracy in this case also. And this is a very simple digital clock without using any interrupt and all, simple this for loop and if condition we have used. So I'll just run this thing and I'll show you how this thing is working. So I'll just rebuilding this. So I have compiled this now. Now if simulation part you will see. So here I'm just, here you can see I have just run this thing. Now here it start. You can see this numbers are incrementing. You can see it is going, when it will be 60 then this will increment. So this way it is working. Okay, so let it go till 60, then we'll see this third segment will increment its value. It's 50 now, 51, 2. See, you can see as our condition is saying that whenever it will be this will be till 6, then this will increment. So that way it is working. When so now this, whenever this will be 10, so this will increment, and when this will be 6, this will increment, and when this will this and this will be 1 and 2, so again all the segments will be 0. So that way we have mentioned in the condition, you can see in the code itself. So if I'll do if I'll tell you like just I'll remove the, I'll just below means like give some less value. Suppose 5 I am giving delay. So now you can see how fast it is going. So you can see, so you can adjust this thing. And even the first if condition, if you will remove that thing, then it will be so fast, because that is also the waiting condition only. We are waiting, we are number of cycles we are increasing, nothing else we are doing on that case. That is only we are doing, that we are increasing our number of cycles in the while loop. So this way this thing is, this digital clock is working. So this this way definitely you, if you make this thing, it will work in hardware as well. Just to do it in hardware, where generally 4 segment module comes, so you can just think the 2 segments also, you can just imagine, and this will be your minute, this will be your hours, you can make like that way. So hopefully you like this video. If you have any doubt regarding this digital clock project, just feel free to comment us below. And in the next tutorials we will start some real things in 8051, like timers, interrupts and serial communication as well. So these things will definitely be come in the next tutorials. So thank you guys, thank you very much.